My name's Ron Winkleman, Fairbanks. New Year's resolution. Probably just like everybody else. You gotta eat the right foods, more exercise, and be kind to your neighbor.
Hi, my name's Wade Ryan. I'm from Unalakleet, Alaska. I like to say hello to my friends and family out in Unalakleet for the natives that were down, and I like to say hello to my baby boy, Derek. There's a heartbeat loud as thunder. There's a heartbeat coming up from deep down under. There's a heartbeat deep inside our mother. There's a heartbeat.
Heartbeat Alaska is made possible by the following. By Coca-Cola, serving Alaska quality soft drinks since 1937.
And by the Alaska Seafood Marketing Institute, educating consumers and promoting sales of Alaska seafood throughout the U.S. and in international markets.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Heartbeat Alaska. I'm Jeannie Green. Thanks for joining us. Hello to Harvey and Marietta Williams. They live in Sitka, Alaska, and recently celebrated their 60th wedding anniversary. Heartbeat is aired over KTNL-TV in Sitka. Congratulations, Harvey and Marietta Williams. On today's program, we travel to Cordova, Alaska, for the second annual sobriety celebration, and what a celebration it was. We travel to Lawrence, Kansas, and learn the history of the Haskell Indian Nations University. Also, Heartbeat Alaska viewers and myself are lucky enough to visit with a Native woman who came here to Anchorage and met her family for the very first time. We have all that plus much more. But first, here's Gary Fife with Native News Across the Nation, and I'll be back in just a moment.
This is Native News Across the Nation. I'm Gary Fife, and best wishes for the seasons. The state of Minnesota has said no to Crazy Horse malt liquor. Indian Country Today reports the state commissioner of public safety has upheld an administrative law ruling and a 1994 law that bans alcoholic beverages that state or imply a false connection with an actual living or dead Native American leader. Descendants of the famed Lakota warrior and leader contended that Hornell Brewing intentionally made such a connection and that defiled the memory of the Lakota who fought against alcohol use by his people. The ruling makes Minnesota the third state to enact such a ban. It's been said that diabetes is among the largest killers of Native Americans in the nation.
People who have lived a sort of a traditional subsistence type lifestyle, when they rapidly change, you know, over a couple of generations to a Western type of lifestyle, that diabetes becomes very common. And this has been observed to happen in Australia and in the South Pacific Islands, and people in India, to some extent in Africa, and most notably to Native Americans in the lower 48 states and Canada. The Pima tribe is probably the world's outstanding example of that, and about one out of every three people in their tribe has diabetes now.
If you are a health professional or a community member interested in finding out how to help others deal with the disease, there's a great opportunity on the horizon. A diabetes and empowerment conference coming up January 8th will focus on personal and community empowerment for Native individuals, families, and communities. The two-day session is scheduled for the Gold River Resort in Laughlin, Nevada. For more information, contact the Health Promotions Program at the University of Oklahoma in Norman. The nation's largest Native American education organization, the National Indian Education Association, has selected new leadership. At its recent 26th annual convention, the NIEA brought out its slate of new officers. Heading the organization is President Alan Sinogeny, Vice President is Lorraine Willis, Treasurer is Greg Mendoza, and Terry Parr Wincoop is the new Secretary. The next NIEA convention is set for October of 1996 in Rapid City, South Dakota. In a period when many museums are examining their Native American collections for articles to be returned to their tribes of origin, the Nez Perce of Idaho have run into a situation where that isn't happening. In the 19th century, a missionary named Henry Spaulding collected several pieces from the Nez Perce culture that are today considered some of the finest in the world. But the legal owners, the Ohio State Historical Society, has called for an end to a long-term loan of those articles to the Nez Perce National Park. Tribal members have protested the return and actually have offered to buy the collection, but yet there's been no response from the Historical Society. And finally, in South Dakota, there's been some meetings and some progress on designing a monument to honor the Native warriors who fought at the Battle of the Little Bighorn in 1876. The panel has been designing the groundwork for the design competition process and has decided on a theme for the proposed museum, Peace Through Unity. The Little Bighorn Battlefield National Monument lies east of Billings, Montana, on the lands of the Crow Nation. For more information on the monument design competition, contact the superintendent's office at the Crow Agency in Montana. And if you have news or information about your Native tribe or organization, please share it with us and put us on your mailing list. And we'd like to say a special hello and welcome to our brand new viewers in Florida, the Seminoles of the four reservations in that state. Welcome. This is Native News Across the Nation. For Heartbeat Alaska, I'm Gary Fife.
Summer, it's time to hit the powwow trail. Going down a hearted, down to the Crow Fair. A thousand fancy dancers from the four directions raise the dust from dusk till dawn. Powwow all week long down at the Crow Fair. Jingle dresses reminds me of the good old days. Take me back in time down to the Crow Fair. Indian revival, cultural survival, hanging on to Indian ways. It's good to be down at the Crow Fair.
They go fast and they're going fast. The biggest selection ever of new Polaris snowmobiles is now available at Alaska Power Sports, but you must shop early. Alaska Power Sports announces our Polaris Fun Dividend Program. Your first check counts for $1,100 on a new 96, and the remaining checks count as $1,000 each. Alaska Power Sports has the largest supply of Polaris parts in the state, and we ship COD to the bush every day. So call Alaska Power Sports at 1-800-478-0500. Alaska Power Sports is the largest Polaris dealer in the world. Alaska Power Sports means Polaris.
1996 is here, and with it come many parties, toasting the new year with alcohol and drugs. Well, let's face it, alcohol and drugs are the number one health problem of Native Americans. Across the board, it is the number one killer. In Cordova, Alaska, they celebrated their second annual sobriety celebration, not by tipping a beer or tipping a glass of wine, but by toasting each other through their native culture, through celebration of each other. And they did it dead sober and had a good time.
The native village of Iak is located in Cordova, Alaska. There are around 500 tribal members made up of Tlingit, Iak, and Aleut. These youth are from Nunwalik, Alaska, with their own rendition of the seal dance, one of many dance groups at the second annual sobriety celebration in Cordova, Alaska.
I myself am a recovering alcoholic. I've been working in this field for the past 25 years.
Ernie Turner is the director of the Alaska Native Alcohol Recovery Center. He's been sober for 25 years, but it wasn't always that way. Ernie had spent 6 years on Skid Row, in and out of hospitals. He had the DTs. He was hit by cars, falling downstairs, you name it. In between the hospital time, he was drunk, and he frequently thought of suicide, but he never had the courage. While he was on Skid Row, he asked God to take his life away. At that moment, two policemen hauled him off to jail, saving his life, putting him in treatment. While in treatment, he again asked God to take his life away, and God did. He took away the drunk life and replaced it with sobriety.
My youngest daughter quit using drugs and alcohol about 3 years ago.
The native village of Iak invited Ernie Turner to speak, as well as many other speakers, and that's the whole point, to share your story. These are success stories, people near death, that have now come back and regained what they once had, the tradition of their ancestors, sobriety. And with this gathering came another cultural event.
The food.
The new year is here, and while others are out consuming alcohol, the native village of Iak in Cordova, Alaska, will be celebrating too. Only their day after symptoms will be strength, hope, and pride.
One step by one mind. Taking that one step, one day at a time, we go one step by one heart. It's never too late to make a brand new start. And all the pain, and all the sadness, finally cast aside. Here, able to share all we've learned about hope and gladness.
You know, someone once told me that it takes more courage to stay sober than to get drunk. Anyone can get drunk, but it takes the courage of a lion to stay sober. And you get the strength of the lion as well. So if you're planning to party this evening for New Year's Eve, give it a second thought. Let's travel now to Lawrence, Kansas. Haskell Indian Nations University has been around a long time and has students from across the nation.
From Alaska to Florida, Maine to California, American Indian and Alaska Native students bring their tribal heritage to Haskell, which creates one of its most unique features, an intertribal university with programs that support the appreciation of cultural values. Haskell was founded in 1884 and is one of the oldest government-supported schools in the United States. It's fully accredited with approximately 850 students representing over 100 tribes from more than 30 states.
Hi, Dom. And now we think of that as a modern value, individual liberty. You can do what you darn well please, and no one has a right to tell you otherwise. I think one of the things that Weatherford tries to raise in here, that sort of value of independence and liberty is not totally European.
One-fourth of them are going to be heterozygous with body color, but they're going to have the dominant because the dominant characteristic is dominant over the recessive one, so therefore they'll have what color?
Gray.
But they will have what kind of wing?
Decidual.
The decidual wing.
Haskell Indian Nations University is located about 35 miles west of Kansas City in Lawrence, Kansas.
Haskell Indian Nations University is one of 27 tribal universities across America. And we'll try and give you more information on Haskell next week, as well as other tribal colleges. Recently here in Anchorage, Alaska, a very happy event took place at the airport. Juanita Pickering finally met her sister after several years of searching. Juanita Pickering's search began in 1988. She was on the phone with her adopted mother, having an everyday conversation, when her mother says that she thought she should find her biological mother. Juanita started to cry. She was happy to hear her give permission to look. On October 7, 1988, she wrote to the Bureau of Vital Statistics requesting a copy of her original birth certificate. Juanita's brother Tony and herself were adopted by Lauren and Margaret Flanders. When she received the copy of the birth certificate, she found out her birth name was Juanita Andrew, and that her mother's name was Elizabeth Andrew, and her mother was born in Kosigaluk, Alaska. She also discovered that she had other sisters and brothers living. One of those was 37-year-old Valeska Ann Stevenson, who was living in Kansas City, Missouri, and working as a medical secretary. She was a single woman. This was her first trip to Alaska since she was 10 months old. With the discovery of Valeska Ann Stevenson, Juanita Pickering's search was over. All five siblings were accounted for. Juanita Pickering's 8-year search was over. The family is looking forward to 1996, having discovered one another. But while she was here, Valeska enjoyed Alaskan hospitality. Juanita and her family served her caribou roast and moose ribs, Eskimo ice cream, lots of native food. Food she's really not accustomed to in Kansas City, Missouri. She's also not accustomed to glaciers, which she visited while she was here on her 4-day visit. 1996 holds a lot of hope for many people across America. Juanita Pickering never gave up. She found her sisters and brothers. And her hope is others in the same situation will be as lucky, as fortunate as she was. As for Valeska Ann Stevenson, well, she'll be back again. Back to Alaska to visit again with her new family. She's taken back with her some fabulous memories. And we here at Heartbeat Alaska wish them a very happy new year. We'll be right back.
share your heart. To make a brand new start. And watch the walls come tumbling down. Siem, we are all family. Siem, we're all the same. Siem, the fire's free.
Take a break now and ring in the new year with some good native music.
Hey. Jole Blon.
As we sign off, we say goodbye to 1995 and hello 1996. It's been a fabulous year, but we look forward to the next one. Currently, Heartbeat Alaska has the largest worldwide audience of any weekly Native American program in the history of television. We're very grateful for that, and we're grateful to you for the video that you send in, for the news that you continue to share. If you don't mind, I'd like to say hello and Happy New Year's to my family, to my mother and father and my sisters and my brother. Happy New Year to you also. God bless. Have a very, very safe evening, and I hope this year brings you happiness and prosperity. For Heartbeat Alaska and all of us here, I'm Jeannie Green. See you next year.
The summer, it's time to hit the powwow trail. Going down a hard end, down to the crow bed. Thousand fancy dancers from the four directions raise the dust from dusk till dawn. Powwow all week long down at the crow bed. Jingle dresses reminds me of the good old days. Take me back in time down to the crow pen. Indian revival, cultural survival, hanging on to Indian ways. It's good to be down at the crow pen. All night. Crow fair, what a sight.
Top 10 things you never hear Native people say. Number 10, I have new tires and car insurance. Let's go to the powwow. Number 9, great speech, Mr. Mulrooney. Number 8,